been good. And me for one, he has been extremely good. I say he has been extremely good. It's been over 2013 till now, and people that knows me, somewhere in 2007, I had a kidney failure, and I was put on dialysis, waiting for a transplant. The transplant, they said my chances of getting one was 1 out of 10,000. But then the body of Christ prayed. We cried unto our God and listened. And he listened. And within exactly a year, I got a transplant. The doctor said, this was a miracle. Because the chance of getting one was very little. 1 out of 10,000, that was too much. I had a transplant for 5 years. And then that one also collapsed. In 2013, April, I went back on dialysis. And I still do. And for people that doesn't know what, actually, I'm not sick, that's why I don't look sick.
That's right.
It is just something that God has allowed for his glory to
be.
And I believe that it is just somewhere, it is now. Say, God, give us a sign. It is now. For the past, just a particular year, most of the people that come to the treatment are people in their 80s. So I have a lot of old people around me. And sometimes they say, we are tired of the treatment. If we are not coming again. If they stop on Friday, in 2 days' time, you don't see them. Where are them? They are dead. They are gone. When they say they are tired, it means they are ready. They are okay. They are going. And within 3 days, you don't see them. They say, yeah, they are gone. They say they got tired of the treatment. But Jehovah God has been so good.
Yeah.
The cost for that treatment per month, there was no way I could have afforded it. But Jehovah God, he has a way of doing his things. I pay literally nothing. And it was the hand of the Lord. Because when the hand of God allows something to come your way as a child of God,
amen,
he makes provision on
us.
And he has provided until his glory will see.
Oh, yes.
With that testimony, in fact, I have written the book. I'm only waiting for the last chapter.
Amen.
And you will hear of it. I just want to thank God for the gift of life.
Amen.
I have had a happy question where they didn't think I was coming back. There are so many times that death has knocked at my door. And then he goes back.
I'm not ready.
And I sleep in peace.
Amen.
Because the hand of God heals me.
Yes.
I don't know what God has promised you and what you are waiting for. One thing I want to assure you today is that he is here.
Amen.
And he hears our prayer.
Amen.
If he has heard Ghana, and now you are not here. By now, your family would have been in the desert running for their life. But he hears our cry.
Yes.
Our God is true. So whatever you are going through, he is so good for you to give up on him.
Yes.
And he has not given up on you. I'm not saying it because of time. He gave me your promises. Assure us day and night. Therefore, grant me grace to wait on you. For what you have promised shall surely come through. Many seek your power, but I seek you all. Many desire to know your big hand. I desire to know your big hand, for I know that where your heart is,
Jesus,
your hand will follow.
Amen.
You will not lie.
Amen.
You will not change.
You will not fail, faithful and true. I say he will not lie, you cannot tell him. You will not change, and you will not fail, faithful and true. Jesus, you will not lie, and you will not change. You will not fail, faithful and true.
In acknowledgement of this and the lives of the people for our deepness, and after that, we introduce the men and women of God. We humbly call Brother Richard for PRBC and Anto to come up front. I humbly ask you to be on your feet. We want to be grateful to our God. In the name of Jesus.